Fire. Sensor reading?
Surface temperature 73 degrees. Atmosphere breathable.
All right, let's put it down.
Okay. Oxygen leak, life support system.
Take over, Tony.
Right.
4 hours until critical level.
Do we abort?
No. You go back to Alpha, pick up another Eagle. Maya and I will have completed our survey by the time you get back.
Check.
Moonbase Alpha to Commander Connie. Go ahead.
Eagle One has developed a malfunction and is returning to Alpha. Maya and I will continue our survey until Tony returns and picks us up.
Anything we can do, Commander?
Just stay in touch.
We'll contact you every 30 minutes to make sure you're all right.
We'll talk to you in half an hour. Out.
Commander Koenig, do you read me? Do you read me? Commander Koenig, come in, Commander Koenig. Do you read me?
They're edible.
Great.
To Alpha. Call it to Alpha. Come in, Alpha. Koenig to Moonbase Alpha. Come in, Alpha.
Welcome, Commander Koenig.
Who are you?
I am the Senator. The citizens of Andera are ready for their games to begin. Sanctioned by the state of Andera, of course. You will serve each other well in this game. I will explain. Here on Andera, we no longer have conflict. Our citizens enjoy self-respect, peace, and affluence. But a high order of civilization does not lift the lower order of passion. And so such passions must be both appeased and controlled. We do this by providing the citizens with an unbroken succession of competitions, passionate games. They will be able to view this event in their own homes. We have selected two teams. It has been 50 years since we last had a contest between representatives from Caligo and Earth. You, Commander Koenig, will represent Moonbase Alpha, and your opponents, the Caligo Galaxy. This is a contest to the death. and you are on the planet Arena, which is a small planet that orbits Andera. It is somewhat similar to Earth, which gives you a slight advantage. Therefore, your opponents have also been given abilities to make all things equal.
Some string. I bet we can make a spear.
Must we kill them?
Maya, yes, if we want to survive.
Well, if we reveal ourselves, it's a sign of good faith. It's obvious we mean them no harm.
You've got a point.
We'll make contact.
Yes, but first, let's make sure we've got some security between them and us. Like a canyon.
They're tracking us. Stay on hard ground. As a friend than as an enemy.
Hello!
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 We don't want to fight with you!
We want to be friends!
But he doesn't.
We're not your enemy!
Now they'll be down on that planet. It's the only place they can be.
Eagle 1 requesting clearance for touchdown.
Eagle 1, Roger. You're cleared for touchdown.
Thanks, Alpha. Do you have another Eagle standing by for me?
Ready for liftoff soon as you clear the launch pad, Tony.
Eagle looking great. You go.
Thanks, Helena.
Moonbase Alpha to Commander Koenig. Moonbase Alpha to Commander Koenig.
Yasko, get that planet on the screen. Where is it?
Should be there.
It's got to be. Check your scanners.
Now, registering.
The sensors are giving no readings.
Eagle 4 ready for liftoff.
Abort, Eagle 4, abort.
What?
Abort!
I've got to get the commander off that planet.
Tony, we don't know where that planet is. They don't like the water.
Maybe they can't swim. Stay here.
Listen to me! Please listen to me! We've no reason to fight! Don't let them make us kill each other! Listen to me!
Even if they can't understand us, they must know we want to talk. Why won't they talk?
Maybe it's their nature to kill, not talk. Well, that river gives us some breathing space.
Maybe they're leaving.
No, just trying to figure out a way across. Well, it'll be a while before they catch up to us. We've got to find some way to defend ourselves. Koenig to Alpha. Koenig to Moonbase Alpha. Come in, Alpha.
Commander Koenig, you waste valuable time. The games have begun. The winners will save their planet from destruction.
Why must we kill to save our lives?
These are the rules of Andera, and they must be obeyed.
We will not submit to those rules. They're cruel and vicious.
Cruel? Vicious? These are the rules of Andera, Commander Koenig. You play or die. If you lose, our games committee will then select a moment at which, for the enjoyment of our citizens, Moonbase Alpha will be destroyed.
We will not fight! We will not submit to those rules!
The games have begun. The winners will save their planet from destruction.
I thought they were against killing.
Obviously, animals are a lower form of life on this planet. If we all kill each other, it's acceptable.
I wonder what abilities they gave our adversaries.
3 against 2 aren't heavy enough odds.
Maybe a lion or a tiger might even out the odds.
No, Maya, he'd tear you apart if you got close enough, no matter what form you took. But wait, maybe we could use your abilities to give us an edge. That way we'd know where they are at all times.
Don't stay in any one place too long.
Stop him! Stop him! We must talk to him!
Come back! Come back! We won't hurt you! Your shoulder. Come on, sit down. Come on.
Now we know the abilities.
They have the same weapons as ours, and they fight by the same book of rules.
One they gave the strength to tear mountains apart, and the other they made a transport.
Yeah, one second the other side of the river, the next second this side. If he could transport, why didn't he do it again to escape?
Perhaps they're only permitted to use their abilities once.
Yeah, it could be. Anyway, thanks.
Nothing to thank me for.
All right, then I thank the bird for its keen eyesight and the lion for its terrible roar.
Oh! Oh, I'm sorry, but I've got to stop the bleeding.
Don't look so sad. It doesn't hurt that much.
Be careful when you move.
Okay, Mom. I won't get it infected and I won't get any dirt in it.
What you need is some rest.
Right, and some peace and quiet. I'm afraid we're not going to get much of that. We'd better take that with us. Give it to me.
It's too heavy for you.
Don't waste time arguing.
Go ahead, Tony.
I'm getting no reading on my sensors.
That was expected, wasn't it?
Well, how about yours?
Still negative. And I still think you're out of your mind.
When I approach the planet, or at least when I think I'm in the area of the planet, I'll check in.
Be careful, Tony.
Oh, you never know. I might even be lucky and make visual contact when I get there.
You should have a co-pilot with you.
I'm not letting anybody else share this risk, Helena.
Remember, you said you'd give yourself a good margin for safety.
What I'm remembering is that I told John and Myra I'd be right back for them.
Better get moving again.
You'd better rest.
We can't stray too far from where the eagle touched down. When it comes back, we've got to be there.
You're getting weaker. What you need is some nourishment.
Oh, sure. How about some pheasant under glass, asparagus hollandaise, topped off with chocolate mousse and cafe espresso?
Some broth. Maybe chicken, rabbit, beef.
Sure. All we need for that are the ingredients. And on this planet, there are no such ingredients anymore.
Well, maybe they didn't kill off all the animals.
Have you seen any around? The only bird we saw was you. If you take another form, don't stay in any one place too long. We mustn't give them a chance to get at you. We also need some more weapons. That lance isn't going to be enough.
go on.
Who says I can't? Check out the area.
There's a long line of animal skeletons all along the rim. Looks like they're in formation.
Battle formation. Could be that this is where the animals made their last stand. The animals wiped out all the plant life in that area to protect their rear. Can you imagine the battle that must have taken place on the rim of this cliff?
And the animals lost.
Yeah.
There's nothing I can see from here.
Why don't you take a closer look, huh?
Right.
Thank you.
knew we're supposed to be resting.
Yeah, I will as soon as I finish this.
I had a great bird's eye view of the valley, but I only saw one of them.
I'd sure like to know where the other one is.
On the valley floor somewhere, I imagine. What are you making?
It's a bolo. In ancient times on Earth, bush natives invented a very effective weapon.
The bolo. Can I help?
Yeah, you can get some more rocks about this size. No, make them a little bigger and round.
Are you all right?
Well, it only hurts when I laugh. Hmm? It's an old Earth joke.
It's not funny.
Well, it was on Earth.
50 years ago.
Okay, then tell me some old Psycon jokes. I'm sorry, Maya. I didn't mean to bring up sad memories.
The memories aren't sad. Except at the end. Psycom was a happy place. That's why most of us wouldn't leave it, even when we knew we faced disaster.
Your brother left.
My brother, like mentor my father, was on Psycom's High Scientific Council. He knew there was no hope when our planet began to boil. So my brother and 1,000 others went off into uncharted space, preferring to take their chances than face sure death.
Did they find another planet?
We never heard from him again. Or any of the others who built spaceships after that and left. As Psycon's temperature kept rising.
If the breakup of the planet was inevitable, why didn't Mentor leave?
My father's dream was to restore Psycon, to make it the beautiful planet it once was. Nobody shared his dream. They all left, preferring to take their chances in the unknown.
But if every scientist on Psycon knew what was coming, why did Mentor remain so stubborn?
He wasn't only stubborn. He was in love. My mother's tomb was on Psycon, and he wouldn't leave her.
What about you?
Oh, he tried to make me go, but I wouldn't. I couldn't let him stay alone.
He should have made you go.
You don't understand. He really believed he could perform the miracle of restoring Psycon. Oh, and I got caught up in that dream. Mentor was a great scientist. And he was my father. I knew he could do anything. I don't see anything.
Yeah.
Must you keep at it?
Firepower, Maya. In a combat situation, there's nothing as persuasive as firepower.
What about you, Commander? Did you have any brothers? Sisters? Mother, father? You had nobody?
I had a wife.
Had?
Weren't there any wars on Saigon?
No. Unlike your planet, we were all of one race, one religion, one government. Our planet was so rich in resources that there was no separation of classes.
In 1987, all the hatreds on Earth between races, classes, and religions all came to a head. The war was global and awful. It was finally the war to end all wars because the survivors realized that if there was another one, it would be the end of humanity.
You mean people killed people just because they were different from each other? That's disgusting.
The one virtue of that war, for kind of a virtue, is that prejudice was wiped out. People realized if they were going to survive, they would have to work together, accept each other for what they were. So we began to create a brand new, wonderful civilization. But it was too late for my wife. She was a casualty of that war.
What was she like?
Helena.
A weapon?
It's just like ours.
He's down there, then.
Carefully, knows we're alerted.
His weapon is still there, but I don't see him.
He's got to be down there.
I don't see him anywhere.
Wind smoke in this direction. Good. Come on. Come on, let's move back. Is right. We've just discovered the third ability. We may not be able to see him, but he's up here somewhere. Maya, you could pick up a scent. Go find him, Maya.
Eagle 4 to Alpha.
Alpha to Eagle 4. Go ahead, Tony.
I'm close to the planet, or where it should be.
You don't have visual. Can you see it?
Nope. But I do have you on the monitor. Do you have me on the screen?
Yes.
How about the planet?
We'll try again. Yasko? Tony, we can't get a fix on that planet. And you can't stay out there forever.
Oh, yes, I can. Send another Eagle to refuel me.
What's that? Look out.
It's all right. It's all right. Shh. Hey. Oh. Are you better now?
What did I do? Pass out?
No. You fell asleep.
As long as I was only delirious, I'd hate to have recurring nightmares like that again.
All right, if it'll make you happy. You were delirious.
That bad, huh?
It has to be cleaned. I've got to find some water.
Go down to him.
We will not interfere.
I will let him kill me.
No.
She can keep that form for only an hour. She will be crushed. Free her, and he can kill me.
We can do nothing further for you.
You can do anything. Wait. Please wait. Wait.
Center. Refueling Eagle coming alongside.
Refueling Eagle is carrying relief pilot.
I don't want a relief pilot. All I want is refueling.
Don't be stubborn, Tony. Let Alan take over.
No way, Helena. One of us taking this risk is all that Alpha can afford.
Eagle 4.
Alongside now, Tony.
Tony, according to our computer, you're drifting very close to our recorded position of
that planet.
According to my instruments, I'm uncomfortably close.
That's what I said. Too close.
I'm still hoping for a visual.
Give yourself more room, Tony. You know, the slightest miscalculation, you'll crash.
Oh, I'm not in the mood for miscalculations, Helena.
How long do you expect to stay there?
Forever, if I have to.
We're fools if we fight. Let her out of the cage. She'll be crushed.
The rule of the game, which incidentally is ended now, states you are a criminal if you do not kill.
No! You are the criminals!
However, our viewers and citizens of Andera have voted that this is a satisfactory conclusion to the competition. It has been decided the planets in the Caligo galaxy and Moonbase Alpha are safe. I will now take my leave. Fun and games are over.
I've checked and I've rechecked, Alpha. According to my inboard computer, I'm at the planet. And yet nothing. Okay, Alpha, I found the planet.
John and Maya, see if you can get through.
Moonbase Alpha to Commander Koenig. Moonbase Alpha to Commander Koenig.
They're letting Alpha make contact.
Anything to get rid of us before we start an uprising.
Moonbase Alpha to Commander Koenig.
Moonbase Alpha, this is Maya.
Go ahead.
Eagle 4 is ready to touchdown if you will give your position.
No need. We have visual contact.